This interesting piece of infrastructure is a modern version of a so-called bear pit, of which you can find examples all over the Netherlands. Although I have never heard that reference being used for this particular one locally. It was built in 2010. This is a turbo roundabout for motor traffic with a T-junction for cycling in its center on a lower level. While people cycling can stay at ground level, motor traffic is led up an artificial hill. So both types of traffic do not have any interaction at this intersection. The steel fence with the arrows on the inside of the roundabout was especially designed to be strong enough to prevent a vehicle crashing into it from falling to the lower level. Drivers of motor vehicles also interact as little as possible with each other. Drivers choose a particular lane for each direction before they reach the actual roundabout. On the roundabout itself, they cannot change lanes due to considerable ridges between the lanes. Drivers of motorcycles are especially warned for these ridges. They could make a nasty fall if they try to drive over them. I'm glad the authorities chose a T-junction, because a mini roundabout for cycling in the lower level would have been unnecessary and unpleasant. Because of the T-junction in the center, three underpasses had to be created under the roundabout. A solution with only two underpasses on the outside could also have been chosen. But then cycling would have had to make a detour. The T-junction in the middle is aesthetically more pleasing and leads to shorter cycle routes. You might ask why there are four arms for motor traffic and only three for cycling. This has to do with the policies of unbundling traffic types in the Netherlands. While through motor traffic is diverted wide around residential areas, people cycle right through such areas. That leads to completely separated routes for people driving and cycling. A waterway was also diverted to flow right through the center of the turbo roundabout, next to the cycle paths. In winter, it is all a bit dull in the lower level of the roundabout. But in spring, many flowers, unexpectedly, make the inside a lovely area to cycle through. Safe cycling infrastructure can, and maybe should, also be aesthetically pleasing.